So guys, in this video, I'll be explaining you the latest type of problems that are being asked in GATE based on swing equation. Swing equation is a very important concept in power system stability. So what is this swing equation? If we write swing equation, there are two forms, H by pi f, d square delta by dt square is Pm minus P. But these powers should be taken in Pu, okay? And here delta is in electrical radian. Similarly, you can use this formula. D square delta by dt square Pm minus Pe in Pu. Here delta is in electrical degree. Or otherwise, if you want to use actual power, M d square delta by dt square is Pm minus P. Usually here Pm and Pe are in megawatt. Okay, so these three expressions can be used as swing equation. Now whatever is this Pm minus P, it is also called as Pa, which is called as accelerating power, because this power is responsible for accelerating the rotor to a higher speed. Is it fine? Now what is this H and M? These both are called as inertia constants. What is the difference between them? The only difference lies in their units. So what is H? H is inertia constant, which has the units of megajoule per MVA. Okay, similarly M is also called as inertia constant, but its units are megajoule second per electrical radian, or it can be megajoule second per electrical degree. There can be two values. Now this M is basically equal to H upon pi f, GH upon pi f for radians. If you want this unit, first unit, it can also be written as GH by 180F for degree. What is this G? G is the MVA base of the system. Because we know in any system we select two base values. One is the voltage base, other is the power base. So this is the MVA base of your system. Okay, that is the relation between the inertia constants. Now how to use this swing equation? See, most of the times what happens, if this accelerating power Pa, suppose it is constant, if that will happen in most of the cases, then this d square delta by dt square by use of swing equation will be how much? It will be Pa into pi f by h. That is basically your acceleration. Now sometimes they may be asking you speed. Speed after n cycles. Okay. So first of all you have to find the time of n cycle. N into T, where T is the time period of one cycle, or you can say N by F. That is the time of N cycles. Now, if this is acceleration, we can use equation of motion, omega equal to omega naught plus alpha T. From here, we can find out the new speed. Similarly, we can find out the new power angle, delta naught plus half alpha T square. Okay. That is the speed and the power angle after n cycles. So here I have just used two equations of motion. Okay, these equations are to be used. Now, let us concentrate on the problem that is given to us and try to apply these concepts whichever I have told you. Okay, this you can apply in the problem that have been asked in recent years. See, it says, A 3-phase 2-pole 50 Hz synchronous generator. So it is 3-phase 2-pole 50 Hz. Which means the synchronous speed is how much? 120 into 50 by 2. That is 3000 RPM. Okay. Then it says it has a rating of 250 MVA at 0.8 power factor lagging. So G, that is the rating, is 250 MVA. Power factor is 0.8 lag. Then it says the kinetic energy of the machine at synchronous speed is 1000 megajoule. So kinetic energy is 1000 megajoule. The machine is running steadily at synchronous speed and delivering 60 megawatt power at 10 electrical degrees. So delta is initially 10 degree and power delivered by machine is 60 megawatt. Why I am writing PE equal to PMC? Under steady state, machine will be rotating at constant speed. So its acceleration, which is initially d square delta by dt square, must be 0. If it is 0, it means PM equal to P. That is, we can say under steady state, whatever power it is drawing from electrical terminals or whatever power generator is drawing from mechanical prime mover, it must be delivering that power to the electrical terminal. If it is a motor, you can say electrical power drawn is same as mechanical power output. In generator, you can say mechanical power drawn is equal to electrical power output. That is why I have written both equal. Then it says if the load is suddenly removed. So load in a generator is electrical. So if it becomes zero, then there will be accelerating power, which is PM minus PE, which is 60 megawatt. Okay. Now we need to find the value of power angle after 5 cycles. Okay, delta we need to find. So first of all, let me bring this into PU. It will be 60 by 250. That is power upon base. That is in PU. Now if you want to find out H, then you have to remember GH is basically equal to kinetic energy of the machine. Okay. It means that what we can say is H equal to 1000 by 250, which means 4 megajoule per MVA. Now I have got H. Now what else I need is acceleration. D square delta by dt square by swing equation will be accelerating power. In degree I need. So 180 into F by H. Okay. So how much will this come out to be? 5, 12, 3, 5, 40. Okay. Now it is asking us after 5 cycle the value of delta. Delta is delta naught plus half alpha T square. So for 5 cycle if I want, we have to first find the time of 5 cycles. As I have told you, the time of n cycle is n by f, it will be. So 5 by 50, that is 0.1. So what will be the value of delta? 10, initial value was given as 10, half into 540 into 0.01. That is 12.7 electrical degree. Okay. This way you can apply the Newton's equation of motion in order to find the value of delta. Suppose I was asking you the speed. So speed could have been determined by two methods. One is omega equal to omega naught plus alpha t. Other was that once you have accelerating power, it was how much? 60 megawatt. Okay, you could have multiplied it by time to find out the change in kinetic energy. 60 into time is 0.1, 6 megajoule. So now what does kinetic energy becomes? Kinetic energy becomes, earlier it was 1006 megajoule. And based on kinetic energy, we can find the change in speed. Because speed is proportional to under root of kinetic energy. So that way we could have also find. Okay. Under root 1006 minus 1000 by 1000. Okay. So that is other way, going by the kinetic energy approach, or you can go by the speed using equation of motion. So that is why students are facing difficulty nowadays, because it is relating the concepts of stability to mechanics. So if you know the concept of equation of motion, you can apply that using swing equation to find out the answer. And you should try the problems that have been asked in 2017 and 2016. Now I hope you will be able to get their answers. Thank you.